Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the 13th video of the Script Manager how-to. With the last video we had a short look about the functionality that can be done with the link processing. Now we'll have a closer look about everything is actually done. So we open the link to the tabs, which is called the script footer links, which we discussed in the first or the second video. It transcludes the list all links elements as a template. This we discussed this in video 10, I think. Okay, let's open the source. There is quite a lot of code in it, and as always, it starts at the bottom. So it says the element is a list element. Is it? It checks for the current tiddler, and every tiddler that is tagged links should be shown. If there is no tiddler which is tagged links, so if this list is empty, it should show the create links tiddler. Yeah? And this is the one which we see here when everything is new, so there is no associated list tiddler. That's why it says create links container. Let's have a look at where it is. So find this one here. Create links, it's just a button which an action element, create container action, then there is a tooltip and create links container. Okay, so container action. The container action is here. Okay, it says set the field of the tiddler. There is a create name, so it is current tiddler plus the dot links element. Yeah, so it sets the field, and it sets the tag create tags, which is current tiddler and links, and then it sets the type to application JSON. Yeah, so that's everything that we know already. If we click the button, it defines a new tiddler dot links, yeah, and it defines the tiddler and tags it with link and new tiddler 3 in this case. Yeah. So this is exactly what happens here. Yeah. So this is create a new tiddler without any dialogues. Yeah. There would be a possibility to create a TiddlyWiki message with a new tiddler, but it will automatically open the tiddler in edit mode. Yeah? And the action set field widgets, they don't have this behavior, they just create the tiddler. But the important thing is that they also overwrite existing tiddlers without any warning. Yeah? So this is important. Okay. So the first element is, or the first part is done. Then now let's have a closer look at the link list. The link list is here. Yeah. So it first shows the name of the current tiddler, yeah, which is this element, yeah, and then it shows the list. Let's go to batch processing, a little bit more interesting. Yeah. So there is the name and there is the list, and it is called link list. So it shows the current tiddler in its own paragraph. Then it defines a new div with the class table, and it has a script link grid, yeah, which we know already. Then we have the table header, which just is this index link in action information. And then there is a new list which is created, and it uses the current tiddler. And current tiddler is now the current tiddler is defined here. Yeah. So and this is the list element. And that's why we can use current tiddler, and then we list all the indexes and we define a variable which is set to list item. Yeah? And this will give us all the indexes which are stored within this tiddler. Yeah? So this is done here. And then it displays the element and it says index text template. Yeah, index text template. Control find, which is defined here. Yeah? So it gives us the box element, and then it says, or it gives us the list item. And then there is the reveal information that we know already, because we have this edit button here. Yeah? So it either shows the content of the line, or it shows the input element. Yeah? And then there is three buttons. There is the okay, cancel and delete. Yeah? So there will be a new macro. Yeah? Then there is the get link, which is very, very similar to the other get link, but it does transclude the index of the current tiddler. Yeah? So there is the list item variable and the current tiddler variable, and the list item variable is set here. Yeah? So list item is dynamically created. Where have we been? Yeah, get link at the get link element, genau. The second element is the edit link input. Edit link input would be here. Edit link input is here. Yeah, it's just the edit template. It uses a temporary tiddler, which is created here. Temp tiddler. Yeah. It is the $temp current tiddler and dot list. Yeah. So temp tiddler, and it edits the list, the index of the list item. Yeah. So this gives us the input element, and it directly edits the entry in the temporary tiddler. Yeah? So if I open the temporary tiddler, temp batch processing, yeah, and the batch processing element, and I open one, then I can see directly edits this entry. Yeah? Okay. So the edit link input. Yeah? Edit link input is here. What else? What do we miss? Yeah, there is the new link. So if I create a new link, I get the second input element, which is very, very similar to the last one that we discussed. Yeah. So we go to the new link input. Yeah. It is also a text edit. It works with the temporary tiddler. It works with the It works with the index, which we called link, yeah? And as we can see here, as soon as we create it, it creates an entry here. This is the temporary tiddler. It creates an entry here, and this gives us the possibility to edit and cancel everything. So this is just stored. The next time we still have this variable, and this is the behavior that I wanted to have. So all the temporary elements, or this new temporary element, should be persistent. Yeah? So that's what I wanted to have. What else is there? So there is the new input, the existing input. Yeah, and then we need the edit link button. Edit link button, which is this one, yeah, which we have here. And this is a macro call to the toggle OK, cancel and delete element. Yeah. So it has, this is part of the toggle me macro. So there should be one toggle OK, cancel, delete. Yeah. This is this one. It has a state. It has open text, OK text, close text, and delete text. Then there is the open action, OK action, cancel action, and delete action. Yeah. So very, very similar to the last input area here. Okay, let's have a closer look what we do there. We give it a state variable. We delete the open text because we just want to have the icons. Then there is the open icon, which is the edit button, the save icon, and then there are the different actions. Then there is the init action, which says init link editor, yeah, which is very similar to the one we know already. It copies the content of the existing list element into the temporary tiddler. Yeah? So it uses the temporary tiddler and the list item index, and the value, it gets the value from the existing list element, list tiddler. So it initializes everything, copies it to a temporary tiddler. Then if we say delete, there should be a delete action. It sets the field of the current tiddler and the index to an empty value. Yeah? And this is a special handling in with the TiddlyWiki core. If you set an index to an empty value, it is removed. Yeah? If I say dollar value is empty string, then it sets it to empty string, but it doesn't remove the element. Yeah? So we have to call the element without any additional parameters, and then it is deleted. Yeah? So there is no action delete field. Well, probably, maybe there is one, but this one also works. And then there is the set link. Set link is here, which copies the content from the temporary tiddler. Yeah? So it uses the content from the temporary tiddler and copies it over to the real list tiddler. Yeah? This is called set link. Okay. Yeah, there is one thing left, which is called record link, and record link is this one. If we have a new one, it copies it to the temporary element if you open it, and this button here is defines the record link element. Yeah, so we have record link and the record link here, which is the part of the new link OK element. So record link is activated and it copies the content from the temporary tiddler from the link index, this element, into the current tiddler with a new index, yeah? And this is the value. Yeah, I think I did cover everything. Yeah, one important information that I wanted to let you know is if you want to create tiddler names, you always have to work with variables, yeah, because otherwise it won't work. So if I create a temp tiddler here, yeah, I say dollar temp, then everything, and this is the variable name of the current tiddler dot list, yeah, and the return value will be a string. Yeah. If you use the macro call here, it won't work. This is really important. Yeah, I know this is a little bit confusing because there is a lot of stuff going on, but yeah, maybe if you have a look at the video a second time and you play with the code, then it should help you and gives you a lot of hopefully useful information. Have fun and see you with the next video, which will be a discussion about how the Togelmi macro was created. Yeah, see you. Bye.